I sound him.
Kris Jenner, I promote the family. Kardashian, think she call me, think she cause she never knew her daddy. And my kids all black, Rhythm Nation chanting, boy don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, what's underground? What's underground? Frontin' like a ride with the mob. Why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I? Play the odds, a yes man, it's just a bobblehead doll. Holler them all. Struttin' like Pac out the court, hop out the Porsche. Shake that, got that. Menu the a la carte. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave. Watch for the sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my age. We was ganging since the platinum FUBU days. I got dreams of being over. I should move in, yay. Listen, babe, listen good. You'll think I'm cool with yay. Okay, my diamonds dancing. I could Lisa Ray. Life is hard, but it's easy being truthful, baby. Baby, for real. Overload. This is like I got like my pinky. Money, baby, we don't. It ain't ours. Bet it back, I bet I match it like the same style. Chopsticks for beef, I'm shutting PF chains down. I gave you prophecy, my first one, then you lame down. Luckily, sold, but it wasn't for me. Still the flow raw. Peep the way I bubble in these streets. Who can f with me?
Nikki, baby.
Go.
Coach, thank you much. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. The City of Angels showing it can be loud and raucous. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad emerged from the tunnel. They're ready for football and ready to watch their Rams do battle with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. And no return on this one as the fair catch. Catch a signal for and take it. Forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Throwing now is Wentz.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
An early test for this defense. Here we go on third and inches. They run for the Jai, and he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. Defense had a chance to get off the field here in the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Here's Ajayi, and this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Snap coming at 1. Now Wentz. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And this is caught at the 20. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Nelson Agholor, 64 yards. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that that was part of their script because so many teams script their opening possessions. And whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play. Go for the big one, and they got it done.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Goff will lead the Rams up here, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. From the gun, here's Goff. Over the middle, that's hauled in by Kupp. And down he'll go at the 25. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
His first catch, good for 9 and a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Goff on first down. Out left, he's got it to Everett. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. A gain of 6 there on first. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. His first catch, good for 16 and a first. Goff in the offense with a first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. To the air again, Goff. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Drops it off to Ajayi. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 7 yards on the play, and it'll make it second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play, 2nd and 3. Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a 2nd and short yardage to start things out. Wentz gonna throw. He's gonna rifle one deep left side. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Here's Wentz to throw. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Aaron Donald with a big-time sack on 3rd down. And it'll be a loss of 7.
82.
Here we go on 4th down with Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 2nd quarter. It to Ajayi, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down, a very solid gain on that play.
82.
Now Wentz throwing on 2nd down. His throw here is incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver, and it's 3rd down.
I think that's a big-time play there, because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
4 minutes to play here in quarter number 2.
Two!
offense on third down. And Tate's got it. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
He used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
82, 82.
From the red zone now, Wentz. That's complete right around the 8. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them. Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7, and a loss of 3 to bring up 4. Wentz going to go on fourth down. This is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Carson Wentz with 2 first half touchdown passes. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Now a loose football. The ball comes out and it's picked up by the Eagles. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. This is Ajayi. A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. Now it's Ajayi. It's a 9-yard gain and it keeps the drive moving.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They picked up another first down with that run.
And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. It's a loss of 4. Now third down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step.
On third and long, it's Wentz. And this is going to be incomplete. Aqib Talib, the veteran Pro Bowler, there to get a hand in, knock it away.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
And the kick by Elliott is good. And that's going to make this a 16-0 ball game. So they recovered the fumble, but ultimately could not take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put six on the board. Ended up settling for three.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. Gone. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Rodney McLeod.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
To throw is Wentz. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play.
And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Aaron Donald in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. On second down, here's Wentz. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. The Eagles on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and forever. Shotgun now for Wentz. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Now on fourth down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
The final shot before break here. Goff. He's going to take another shot. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Here's a Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, you get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Goff now looks to throw. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool. instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Run.
Wentz now on first down. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Wentz now hitting on two-thirds of his passes, 10 for 15 so far, first and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. A dump off to Sproles. And he is into the end zone, touchdown, Philadelphia. Three touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. Elliott on for the extra point. Elliott good with a PAT, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken short. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. And the Rams getting set to go now. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Well, if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
Now Gurley, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of 2, now third down.
The best offenses and the ones that win are ones that make adjustments. And right now, I think this team needs to open things up.
On third down, they'll run it with Gurley. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. He did well to get him 8 yards, but it's still going to mean a call to the punt team on fourth down. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
By 20. 5.
They are going for it. Goal. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout.